Welcome to Wiki Bearings, where we dive into the worlds of engineering excellence, from the automotive marvels to the industrial giants. Join us to explore the wonders that keeps the world in motion. My name is Hassanein Alwan, and I'm your host. In today's episode, we're going to talk about the best bearing brand in the market. A question that no one is willing to answer. What is the best bearing brand in the world today? We're going to talk about six brands that is covering the premium segment of the market. Of course, there are thousands of smaller players, specialized companies, and so on. Bearing is a sophisticated industry that requires years of experience to perfect the bearing production. From the steel manufacturing to the details, to the turning, heat treatment, lubrication, name it. It's a whole range of iteration to perfect that small bearing that we use every day. Globally, there are few companies that dominate the market, at least the premium market. Now, there are many other specialized bearing companies that are specialized sometimes in linear motion, split bearings, needle roller bearings, and many other specialized industries. But we're going to today talk about the six best brands in the market. And these brands are the ones that are having the widest range, and they cover most of the industry. Now, all of these brands are well known, and they have, some of them have more than 100 years of experience in this industry. Some of them are even started before this century, 1988 and so on. Let's start with the first company, Svenska Kullagerfabriken, SKF, a well-known Swedish company established in 1907, one of the largest and the oldest bearing manufacturer, more than 100 years of experience. Sven Winquist, a Swedish engineer, invented the self-aligning ball bearing, and he is considered the founder and the guru behind the SKF company. The company has a wide range of automotive and industrial bearings. They are well known, not only exploring Earth, but exploring the space. It says that Apollo mission lunar landers had SKF bearings, and you can see that technological advancement. Today, SKF is doing more than $10 billion of business, and they are available in more than 40 locations in the world. Moving to Japan, let's talk about NTN, or what we call it, NTN Corporation. Of course, it's a Japanese-based company established in 1918. It is the first company in Japan to produce ball bearings, has supplied precision bearings for use in JAXA, Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, for satellite and exploration missions. NTN owns many well-known brands in the market. Recently, they acquired, not recently, like 15 maybe years ago, they acquired SNR, and they own as well Bauer and BCA, the two American well-known brands. Today, NTN is doing $6-7 billion of business. That is depends on how we count the yen. So if we look at today's yen, it's maybe 6 billion. If you look last year's yen, it's maybe more than 7 billion. Schaeffler Group, a German family-owned business, one of the few and probably the only company in among the six big boys that is a family-owned. This company was founded in 1946 and today owns many well-known brands like INA, FAG, and Luke. Well-known player in the bearing market with full range of bearings and power transmission products for automotive and the industry. Schaeffler has also made significant contribution to the motorsports, particularly in Formula E, the electric street racing series. The company developed an innovative electric drive system for the Audi Sport ABT, Schaeffler team. Today, Schaeffler is doing $14 billion, or if we look at 12 billion euros. 12.4, 12.6, depending on the exchange rate. Another important Japanese company, Nippon Seiko KK, the short name for NSK. NSK is, of course, a Japanese company, as the name says, founded in 1916. Again, it's a well-known company and with a long history. Takehiko Yamashina, the founder of NSK, initially had a deep interest in reviving the traditional art of Japanese sword making. Yet, as Japan's industrial landscape began to expand, he saw a significant opportunity and shifted the focus from swords to manufacture bearings. In 2021, NSK did 720 billion Japanese yen, which is in today's exchange rate something around $6 billion. And it is one of three big players in Japan in the bearing industry. The third player is Koyo, or what we call them today, JTECT. Koyo was established in 1921, and today JTECT owns Koyo and they have some other brands under them. JTECT is a Japanese company that owns the Koyo brands in the bearing business. JTECT was formed through the merger of Koyo Seiko and Toyoda Machine Works. Not Toyota, but Toyoda in 2006. Actually, Toyoda Machine Works used to be part of the Toyota Group. So as you see the name, there are lots of similarity in the name. And this is explained the close relation between JTECT and Toyota as a supplier and customer. So JTECT today supply lots of automotive components for Toyota cars. And many automotive bearings are today produced in cooperation with Koyo. If we look at JTECT as a group, today doing something roughly around $12 billion, I would estimate the Koyo business to be something around $4 billion. Last but not least, let's talk about Timken. It's an American manufacturer. Timken was founded in 1899, the oldest company of all the bearing companies, by Henry Timken. Henry Timken, a carriage builder who invented the taper roller bearing to solve the problem for frequent wagon breakdown. In the early days, Timken had almost 90% of the U.S. market for taper roller bearings, but they were mainly focusing on the tapers. In recent years, Timken understood they cannot compete in this global market without expanding their range, and focusing only on taper roller bearing will not do the game. So Timken put a very steep growth target and starting to acquire well-known brands in the industry. Example is Philadelphia Gear in 2011, Rollon Group in 2018, and as you know, it is a linear motion specialist. Diamond Chain Company in 2019, it is a chain manufacturer, and Beka Lubrication in 2019. Specialize in lubrication system and auto lubrication system. Now, Timken is one of the big players in the bearing world with estimated turnover $4.7 billion. These are the six main players in the bearing world. All of them offer a wide range of products that cover many industries, automotive, industrial, agricultural, name it. Of course, there are many smaller and more specialized bearing manufacturers that focus on some specific ranges or are more into a niche side of the business. Can be eccentric, can be split bearings, can be linear motion, and so on. Nachi is one of them. It's a company that focuses on ball bearings. Of course, it's a Japanese manufacturer. Nachi was established in 1928. In Toyama City in Japan. And throughout these years, they have focused primarily on ball bearings, spherical roller bearing, and some clutch bearings. In the past few years, they saw the significant growth of robotics, and now the company is very much focused on robotics and automation. And they started also outsourcing some of their automotive production. If we look at today, Timken is doing something like $2 billion, not so bad for a few ranges. Other companies in the specialized space like THK or Highwind, these are more linear motion company, THK is a Japanese brand that specializes in linear motion products, including linear bearing, linear guides, and actuator. They are known for their precision and innovation in the field of linear motion. If we look at Haiwan, it's a Taiwanese manufacturer recognized for their wide range of linear motion products, including linear guideways, ball screws, and linear bearings. It's one of the only well-known Taiwanese company in the bearing business. Other industries like needle roller bearings, two Japanese names will come to the mind, IKO and JNS, specialize in needle rollers and linear motion as well. But of course, needle roller bearings and linear motion are produced by many of the big boys, INA, NTN, SKF, and so on. So they are not the only bearing or needle roller bearing manufacturer. Last but not least, let's talk about split bearing. There are only three companies that are dominating this niche market: Cooper, Revolve, and Bowman. These brands are very, very niched into split bearings, cylindrical, sphericals, and so on. They're purely into the industry. Today, SKF own Cooper brand. It was acquired in the past few years. Cooper is a well-known brand and manufacturer for split roller bearings. Of course, if we look at it, Timken acquired in the past Revolve, offering as well split bearings and split cylindrical roller bearings. These are the two well-known brands in that, and they are the main competitors, the main players in this industry. Other companies, NTN, NSK, and some SKF still do some of these split bearings, but they're not doing that as wide range. They do some of these, but these companies are the ones that are specialized in split bearings. If we look at the latest player in this market, we have to mention Bowman. Bowman is a new player in the market. They are using 3D printing as their competitive edge. So they cut cost and deliver much faster. Like, they cut cost and time using 3D technology to print these bearings. It's a UK-based company. It's a very interesting company to look at. They are the latest comers in split bearings. Now, we looked at the top six players in the bearing market: SKF, FAG, NSK, Koyo, Timken, and Schaeffler. As I said, there are many smaller players, specialists in the industry, and they focus on very niche markets. Of course, if you would like us to cover some brands or some special industry or some special segments, don't hesitate to contact us or to leave a comment. We are here to help you and look at the different bearing brands. Now, let's look at what is the best bearing brand for you. What is the best bearing brand for your customer? What is the best bearing brand for you as a company? Could be an end user, if you are a sugar manufacturer, or if you are a supplier in the industry, or for the automotive engineering. What is the right bearings for you, or the right brands for you? Now, if we look at it, I would summarize it. The best bearing company for you would be the company that can offer you the right bearing at the right price at the right time, but with the right technical know-how and support. You need these elements. You need the balance of these elements. Without that, you wouldn't know. And without that, will not be the best bearing brand for you. Today, there is a jungle of brands. There is so many distributors. There are so many companies. But this is the balance you have. And if you look at around you, if you have any distributor that have one of these well-known brands, and they can give you the right bearings at the right time, at the right price, with the right support, these are the best company for you, or the best brand. Now, of course, every brand have its strength and have its weakness. Japanese tends to have a very long delivery time, so but they tend to be also very cost effective. European have much more wider range, wider support, and so on. This would give you, each brand would have their niche and segments and strength. As we saw, Timken is strong in taper roller bearings. NTN is strong in maybe ball bearings, needles, and so on. Every company would have that niche that they are strong in. So depending on your industry, depending where is your most important brand. So if you are in the automotive for Japanese cars, then probably one of the three Japanese NTN or NSK or Koya would be the right bearing brand for you. If you are in, let's say, truck business and you're looking for taper roller bearings, then NTN and Timken are very good brands for you. So it's difficult to say what is the best bearing brand for you. But I would say, looking at your market, looking at your segment, looking at your local distributors, this is how you choose the balanced choice for your bearings. We at Mineral Circles Bearing would love to hear from you. If you have any comments of what we said, if you would like to know more about any episodes or anything around bearings, power transmission, electrical, vehicles, and so on, please don't hesitate to contact us. And we are here to help you, and we are here to give you the best bearing brand for you. And that wraps another episode of Wiki Bearings. Don't forget to subscribe for more insight into the fascinating realm of the engineering innovation. Until next time, keep spinning towards greatness.